In this video, we're going to be taking a deep dive into the advanced filtering type within the filter pane. And in my opinion, this is the best possible route for you to get the best and quickest insight as a consumer. So let's go ahead and try it with our customer field. If we open up the customer field and we go to the filter type, we go ahead and click the dropdown, we click advanced filtering, we get this different view here, and immediately you can see that you can see a different set of conditions or rules. Now, what I want to point out here is that the customer field is just a bunch of words and letters and store names. So when we type something in our text box here, it would have to be in the form of letters or words. And it can be case sensitive sometimes, so just be careful of that. But let's go ahead and try it. Let's say we want to look up a customer that contains the letters C and O right next to each other. Let's go ahead and apply this filter, and then boom. What you officially just did is say, hey Power BI, hey data, look up every letter that has C and O right next to each other in my customer field, and the data set backing this dashboard to only show that. And what we got was this customer called Cantoso, Cantasco, Canticio. I don't know whatever it's called, but you're officially a data ninja, and that is your first step into advanced filtering. Let's go ahead and remove this filter, and let's check out the other statements or rules that we can do with this advanced filtering option. So if you hover over one of these rules, you can see exactly what that rule might mean. And as you scroll through these, you'll see the different ones that say, does not start with, is not, is empty, does not contain. All of these can be applied to the advanced filtering type. And just a heads up, as you're taking a deep dive into these rules, is that some of these might not be applicable to the field that you're searching. So for the customer field, some of these might not make sense for something that might make more sense for like a number or like a date value, something along those lines. So just a heads up as you're looking through that. Now, a real world example of how powerful this can be is sometimes when the data comes back, it might not show in a perfect row all the data. Sometimes there is multiple customers and addresses that would roll up into, let's say, the same type of entity or store. And one way to combat that to make sure that you're getting all the data is to go to the advanced filtering and then do contains. And then if we're just trying to look up Microsoft sales, just look up micro. And that will return all of the customers that contain micro, so you can get that full look of all the net sales that might have been under Microsoft as a customer. We can also combine rules with the and or selection here. All right, let's say we want to capture every customer that starts with the letter L. We're gonna select our or here, and let's snag another customer. So let's do another starts with rule here, and let's grab every customer that starts with F. Let's apply our filter. What we just did is search our whole data set to see what customers start with the letter F and the letter L. And these are only two that are returning. And it looks like Fama and Leo as our two winners. If we go back to our filter and we select the and selection, we apply that filter, you'll notice that the dashboard will return blank. The reason for that is because it's impossible to have a customer name start with the letter L and the letter F at the same time. When you select and, you are telling Power BI that it needs to make sure that both of those conditions are true in order for it to pass any data. Now, the reason that we got data back when we selected OR was because both of those statements didn't have to equal true in order for it to pass data. Only one of those could start with L and the other could start with F. That's how our dashboard got populated. Let's move on to the date field. Now, if you can master the date field within the filter pane, I promise you're going to be a data ninja from here on out. Now, it's common in other Power BI applications that the developer would put a dashboard level filter of a date field, and it looks something like this, where it has two knobs and you can easily customize the dates that you want. Let's go ahead and try this puppy out. Let's say we don't want to look at any sales in January, we only want to get the all-in sales for February to June. What we can do is we go to our filter here and say, hey, return back everything on or after February 1st of 2019 and return that back. Let's apply that filter, and you can see it just chopped up everything that was January and returned everything after February 1st. Now, in my experience, users like to specify between two dates, And we can go ahead and do that by making sure that we have and selected so that both these statements or rules have to come back as true. And we click on is before, and let's say we want to do, May 1st of 2019. So we're only going to look at February to basically the end of April. Let's apply the filter here. And then now we are granted with the all-in net sales of 389K, and we can see the trending per week, per month, and per quarter from the dates that we specified. Now, if your Power BI environment updates every day, this filter type of relative date would be a really useful tool for you to use. Now, a common use case I see this with users is that they like to specify how many months or years back from today. So let's say today is January 21st. I want to look at 3 months from today. That is a common use case. Or they want to do years or days, or you can even do relative time where you can show hours or even minutes. It is really up to you and how you want to slice that. Now this sample data is only from 2019, so this filter type of relative date might not be as applicable, but keep this in mind when you're comparing this to your current Power BI applications.